to one of War Thunder's training areas. Here, you will learn how to begin. Follow the waypoints to the firing area.
Thank you.
corner, you can see a mini-map which shows your tank. Your opponent this time, a training target, is the red icon on the map. Your allies' icons are blue. You can see several markers on the screen. The cursor, which the turret of your tank follows, the marker indicating the... Take into consideration that the mouse aiming cursor is not a gun sight and only serves to help. If you want to hit the enemy tank, wait for the turret to turn towards the opponent. Align the crosshair with the target. It will change color when it is over the opponent. And fire. Move the cursor. Wait until the tank turret finishes rotating and the weapon sight to be unlocked. Switch to gunner view. You can use zoom to get a better view. The aim assist indicator in the center of the screen. It turns red if the current shell cannot pierce, depending on your target's armor thickness. One of the best ways to destroy a tank is to put its crew out of action. Move the reticule over the central area of the tank. Now, fire at the fighting compartment on the tank.
Yes, I hit!
Got it! When a shell penetrates armor, the X-ray window appears in the top right corner. The enemy tank is considered destroyed if it has... Another effective way of destroying, or at least if most armored vehicles have their engines at the rear. Continue by moving the reticule onto the rear of the indicated tank. Now, switch to gunner view and fire at the tank engine.
The gun's reloaded! It serves him right.
If the engine, ammo rack, or fuel tanks inside the tank are damaged, now you have to complete a... You can see a marker above the capture point. If the marker is white, move to the capture zone. return to the capture zone and wait for the marker to turn blue and for a message to appear.